Hello boys and girls, welcome to peek over my shoulder in Lifeless Planet. Okay, it seems that the tightrope is not a viable option, which means we're going back to the lab. So yes, in the previous episode I was trying to force my way past the upper cord or upper rope onto the lower one, and when I started recording right now I had just managed to jump on top of the crossing point, and I was ecstatic that I was gonna make all the progress and skid my way across, but it appears that this tightroping across is not actually the viable option there. So I'm going for the lab entrance. I think we have to go around a little bit. Yeah, there's the path down. She's still sitting there? Be physically exhausted, might be a lack of sunlight because photosynthesis, yo, or might be having a bit of a besought moment because this must be the lab where they did all the experiments on her and pumped her full of green goop, and now she's like science magic and stuff. Oh, and also from the science logs, turns out that her name is actually literally Aelita. So I had been nicknaming her own name actually. To do is step into the thingy instead of, I don't know, doing crazy acrobatics and shit. At least for the moment, the extra jetpack seems to be more like a safety feature for traversing the crater. Come on now, we were doing so great. We were making progress, yo! Come on, don't get stuck on some beams. Oh! She's on the move. Okay. Whee. green trail seems to grow more abundant now. Like, at the beginning of the game it was kind of fickle and frail. But now, I can see it a mile away. Trouble breathing. Scout ahead, but there will be doodad chasing. Oh, there's some sort of portal there. Okay. Oh, there's a whole lot of structures here. Like a stargate, is she gonna disappear? Okay, stay put. I will check for everything else. I guess we have to get this thing working so that she's marking the spot where some interaction is needed to, you know, get it into working order. We still have the jetpack, don't we? Shit. Oops! Shit! Ow! Fuck. Okay, and she's already there. Why I'm so adamant about using my jetpack now is that I'm afraid the extra fuel will be taken away from me. Although I could just go, I think right now I have access technically to the tank, so maybe, yeah, looks like this area requires jetpack use, so we're good. No panic. These like their tracks or running water or what? I'm pretty sure she will stay put at the portal. Green glowy stuff everywhere. out of what we had, levitating stuff. I take it to get one thing working, we need to get the series of these things working. Okay, there's some green stone there. This area is not meant to be accessible, but jetpack, yo. Oh, invisible border. Okay, never mind then. Funk. It, we need to get this working, at least to a point, and I'm guessing that to get this working we need to power up those two nuggets there. And to power up those two nuggets we're gonna have to put greenstone in it, in them. Greenstone there, and there's one on top of that thingy. Let me quickly examine this nook here. Using my jetpack powers. Oh, it is just another rock. Instruction or something. Heyo.
The Russians were studying these alien structures. What were they looking for?
Okay, so the other one will require some jumping, I guess. There's the other one might be different. It has the nest here. Okay. have glyphs. Okay, so this one has something, and the other one... Is she on the move? No, not yet. Do we have a glyph on this one? Oh, it doesn't seem so. Okay, let's go check on her. I think she has moved, maybe? Also, lava, magma. Before there was certain green mist around the place where she was sitting, but how about now? Oh, okay, she's in the place. Never mind then. Whee! Obviously another portal there, so we will obviously have to get over there somehow. Either by jetpack or by some path. I think it's just a matter of jetpacking. Or is it? Pretty high. Let's see. I mean, the two nuggets are powered on, but the central structure doesn't seem to be. Oh, maybe I have to do something with the glyph thingy. Something, but what? Did anything light up on the main thing? Doesn't seem so. Let's go poke at it again. Maybe we have to like pull it or something. Randomly at buttons you don't know. Oh, now it powers up I guess it functions the same way as the gate buttons do, like you have to hit the right ones in a row. Ooh. Oh my! Oh, okay, so this is how you travel to the next one. Gotcha. Elevator, or like transporter. Tractor beam. Wait. Why was she carried, but I have to actually walk? Transporter until we get the beam going and point it to the next one. There, I'm gonna take it. Before I do that, I will check for crystals and artifacts, of course. Here we have something different. But the common element seems to be that you have two nuggets that need to be connected somehow. I'm still gonna check the plateau for doodads. One of them seems to be the receiver, the other seems to be the sending end. Another thing with the collectibles is that there's no way to check how many I actually have, so it might very well be that I have them all and I just don't know. Oh, we have to do some cubing here. Maybe. Or maybe the cubes will work on their own once those parts are powered up. We should see. Artifacts. Okay, let's go manipulate that pastor. Thank you. about the middle one. Let's try. Oh, okay, so the middle one is the right one as well. Ooh, oh, hello. What do we have here? Yoink. So I take it one component is this. Magnetism is here. I'm guessing that another component is the doodad on this little plateau. Ah, yeah, these now glow. Do I need to do something further with them? Okay, so I need to put them into a sequence, like a key or something, I guess. Just a wild guess that this one should... Oh, okay, now I see. So one should go over there. Three stones, three gaps. Another gap? Is this like double slot? Can't tell. Oh no, that's single, okay. And now I need to move this one away. Because otherwise I can't push either of those. So that there would be a clear path between the golden elements, maybe. So that's why I can push this one farther away. If I can. Well, that doesn't seem to be the case. Let's see. Can I push it away like this? Wide enough for two. No, not like this. So now I can push these. Thank you. Since I have moved this one past this point, let's try. Then I can move this one away. But I won't be able to put the other one past this one. Okay, I think I got it. And now, if I push this one here, remain, and you two can snap together. Joy! This one is on the way, kind of. Let's try to make it work. So we need to get that one away as well. How do I get this one past it? So like, if I move this one out again. Okay. This one is out of the way anyway, so. Moment of truth. Oh, okay. Now I see what's happening. Hello. Ow. It didn't even occur to me to look over here to see what's happening. there, you didn't want to fall off.
Наши ученые сделали сегодня удивительное открытие. Прежде мы думали, что создатели портала либо покинули эту планету, либо были убиты местными обитателями. Но мы ошибались. Создатели портала оказались более развитыми формами, похожих на растения существ, которыми покрыта поверхность этой планеты. Они, должно быть, колонизировали эту планету много тысячелетий назад, привезя с собой разнообразные виды схожих культур, чтобы засеять ими всю планету и сделать ее пригодной для своего обитания. Мы, собственно, думаем, что обитатели этой планеты представляют из себя не столько отдельных индивидуумов, сколько нечто вроде плотной глобальной сети. Конечно, здесь есть более маленькие, более большие породы и их разновидности, но все они, как кажется, могут общаться друг с другом через повсеместно распространенный мох, зеленый огонь, который так необходим для всей жизни на этой планете. Принимая все это во внимание, и то, как их корни могут также имитировать бесконечное количество форм, мы явно имеем дело с более высокоразвитой и необычайной формой жизни.
Cool. And of course you killed them all. Or they don't want us here. Okay, so this one takes us across, which means I will examine this bottom here, which is the case, you never know. Are we good? What's happening? Okay, it might be that we need to turn some next doodad on. Uh oh. It's over there. Uh-oh. Oh, she took us to the forest. How nice. Are we still in this planet or are we hallucinating? I mean, we are low in oxygen after all, and we have no jumping capabilities. Uh-oh. With me? This is some Solaris level shit right there. What's over there? So did she just summon like a forest here for us or what? Ah no, that's just our dying brain. Formation. I think they did. Or maybe if you miss, then it resets itself. I don't know. Okay, that's the root creature right there.
Hold on, I'm coming!
You're not. You're like one step from Blairg. Where are we even going? Okay, this might not be the way. Itself. So is it this one? Oh, I should have. Shit! 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 No! Nightmare physics not included. She's the one with the roots. Oh, that's it. I think I can reach it from here. Like I can't get this high up, but I can make a long jump. That counts. Come on. This is the closest I think that I've come. Got it. I hear life forms. I guess Aelita has maybe joined with the whatever thingy this is? Or are we underground now? At least we got out of the nightmare. Okay. This is a whole new area. I think we might be closing in on the end game, but before I research further, I will start a new episode. Thank you very much for watching. I will see you in the next one. Bye!